For so long I carried the weight of my past, crippled by burdens like stones on my back. I thought I had fallen too far from your grace.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you today.
When I was lost, so searching, you were the ground beneath my feet. When I was a blind man begging, you were the eye so I could see.
Welcome to Worldwide Recovery Radio. Let me try and speak into the microphone here and not chew it up. My name is Mike. Good morning to everyone out there. I hope you're doing really good. Kind of a fun day, Halloween.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, you know, you got to love little kids getting dressed up and trying to walk.
Getting hopped up on sugar.
Candy party. And trying to hold the Halloween basket or bag and walk and everything else.
And steal their brothers and sisters' candy. It's all in good fun.
It is pretty comical to watch, isn't it? It's a lot of fun. So, anyways, welcome to the Recovery Radio. Listen, it's going to be a show about you.
Mm.
The show is called Confession today. So we definitely want to hear from you.
Yeah.
We want to hear about you. We want to hear your process of confessing.
Yes.
Or maybe you're holding on to something that's pretty challenging and you're struggling. Hopefully, Val, we can help them through that today.
Yes.
And speaking of Val, good morning to my co-host.
Well, good morning.
So she's the one that actually kind of keeps everything going and in line, and we're thankful for you.
That's a little scary.
Yeah, it is.
That's a
full-time job that you have. Yes.
Herding cats, y'all.
Yes. Thanks a lot. Yes. Cats. Okay. And in our studio with us this morning, as always, Bill. Good morning.
Good
our
morning.
Engineer. We're thankful for you. Val, you want to open up in prayer?
I'd love to. God, today I thank you for your mercy and your grace. God, I ask that you are with all of us today, that you speak through us, you use us as a conduit, Father, to reach those that might not understand how important confession is, Father. Just show them your light, and in Jesus' name I pray, amen.
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 You know, Share-a-thon is coming up pretty soon, a couple weeks, Bill, huh?
A week from this coming Monday.
Yeah, see? Yeah. See, so it's
so
it's,
fast.
It's coming up pretty quick, so we really appreciate the AIR team members and all the support. Actually,
yes.
The AIR team members provided funding for this new studio.
That's right.
And has actually allowed the program to begin, because in talking to Farron 7 years ago, we didn't have the equipment for a call-in show and to send it out the way it should be, and it took about 5 years.
Yeah.
And so
yeah, if you want to learn about persistence, call Mike Cardello. He'll tell you all about
my
it.
My gosh.
Well,
man.
Call Farron and
he'll
talk to him
explain
about
yeah.
how Mike Cardello was in his office.
Let me tell you, I always showed up. He sent me out for another task to accomplish, and 2 weeks later I was back. It was like a bad penny or something. And I'm like, "Oh no, really?" Yeah, so
that lint in your pocket that never seems to go away.
It just doesn't go away.
When God
how does
gives
it get
you.
In there? First of all, it's crazy, isn't it?
It's, it's
so
wild.
we're now that we've chased the rabbit, we're back to the AIR team members, and we're so thankful. So again, if you don't know what that is, it's someone who supplies monthly $25
or more.
Yep. Yeah. So that is so important because you know you think, oh, okay, $25 a month, but if you if you have 10 people, all of a sudden, okay, that's $250 a month coming in for equipment and towers and everything else. And there's such a need. And if you, obviously, electronics is not cheap.
Right.
So so there's such a need. So anyways, for us in our Recovery Radio show, we have had just a jump in our sponsorship. People are really
praise God,
really, and so they sponsored this particular show, and you can do that also. So Val, you want to let the people know who our sponsors are today?
I'd love to. So Easy Rider Motorcycle Testing, now hiring riders, located at 1080 Aviation Drive, or by phone 928-706-4553. Serve Pro of Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, and Kingman. Family owned and operated. Residential and commercial restoration and cleaning services, located at 2775 Kiowa Boulevard North. They can be reached by phone 928-855-9124 or on the web at ServPro Lake Havasu City, Bullhead City, Kingman.com. Next is Ohana Poke Bowl, bringing authentic Hawaiian poke bowl and Hawaiian foods to you. Located at 3269 Maricopa Avenue in the Bashes Shopping Center, on the web at ohanapokelhc.com or by phone 928-733-5104. We also have Ace Pest Control, serving the Lake Havasu City area for 20 years with termite, pest, and weed control. By phone 928-680-0988 or on the web acepestcontrolaz.com. Sunshine RV, experience sales and service at its best with Kyle and the gang. Located at 2995 Maricopa Avenue, new Northside location on Highway 95 near Dillard's at the shops. They're on the web at sunshinerv.com or by phone 928-855-6648. Next, we have Print It Havasu, black and white or color copies, graphic design to print. Route 66 Souvenirs and Christian Gifts, located at 2018 McCulloch Boulevard North. You can reach them at 928-505-0451. We also have Hilltop Community Church for supporting Recovery Radio with our shirts and hats, located at 3180 McCulloch Boulevard North or on the web at hilltoplhc.com. Lastly, we have the anonymous sponsor. You know who you are, and God knows who you are. Thank you so much.
Yeah, amen. Did you hear all those sponsors? Isn't that amazing?
Yeah, that is
just
awesome.
Amazing, and we thank
you. I'm tired.
You. Yeah, that was a workout. Yeah, so we appreciate you so much, man. We're so thankful of those that that sponsored this program and the ones that pray for us and give as air team members. You are also part of this program, so... we can't mention everyone's name, but these are particular sponsors that sponsor this show, and we're really thankful for them. So amen. Let me tell you a little bit about this show. It's a live call-in show, and we are podcasting now simultaneously into lots of different avenues and places, and it's pretty amazing that we've come so far so quick.
Yes.
And we've reached people all over. When I say worldwide, we have heard from many countries. We get emails and some phone calls, and many people in the United States praying for us, calling in, emailing. And we respond to those, and we're really thankful for the communication and the prayers, because we could use it.
Yeah.
You know, it takes a whole team all week just to put this one-hour show together. It takes a lot of work and a lot of volunteers, and we really appreciate the dedication and hard work. Our number, 1-800-721-9313, and the local number, 928-855-9110. And the show is about recovery, and I you know, you hear the words recovery, and the first thing you think, oh, well, I don't have a drugs or alcohol problem.
I never
had that problem, Val. Don't have that situation. Recovery is kind of a mistaken word.
Yes.
You can have a struggle or a challenge within your life, and you really need to recover it. So what this show does, hopefully it brings you some understanding, and it gives you resources, because on our website, and Val will give you that later, there's tons and tons of resources for you to get information to help you through your struggles. We've had probably maybe 70 guests in different testimonies. And
it's incredible.
And Val, you just gave your testimony at Hilltop CR. And let me tell you, that was probably one of the most powerful testimonies that I've ever heard. So it was absolutely wonderful.
Yeah, allowing my story to show God's power has been a joy for me, because I know that He's using all of that darkness and all of those terrible things that either I did or were done to me. He's going to use that for His purposes. He's making a way for somebody else to walk through that and to understand that there's always hope.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we're here to help one another for sure. And hopefully we inspire you. Maybe today is your show because you're struggling with confession. Maybe you're carrying a secret that is really just kind of tearing you apart. And maybe today is the day that you confess it to God, to somebody else, and receive some healing. And we'll talk about that today later. So real important. Real important stuff.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's key in recovery.
It is. If you don't confess, you don't heal.
That's
you don't recover.
Says
so I mean, it's pretty simple.
God's
I mean, you can't recover from drinking if you're going to the bar drinking. So, right?
How's that for wisdom, y'all?
You know, it just hits the point. It doesn't happen. So when you confess, then God's right there, and there's nothing like. Although it is pretty hard, you know, when you have a secret, because what does Satan say? Oh, don't tell anybody. Mm. They're going to think.
Why would you share that?
Oh, they'll think they won't even talk to you again. Probably, you know what I mean? And and that fear and everything else. So, what we're not?
Yes, what we're not is we're not here to fix one another. We are here. We don't have that kind of power. Only Jesus Christ does. The Bible states we are to share each other's burdens, come together to encourage one another and build each other up and lift one another in prayer.
Yeah. Amen. That's good stuff. Mm-hmm. Lift each other in prayer.
That's right.
That's where we're at. Better together.
Absolutely. Yes.
We got to have each other through all kinds of things. So.
And hey, and if this introvert can get on the radio and talk and tell people all her most secret things in life, then I promise you there's hope for anybody out there to be able to follow that process of surrender and confession and willingness to abide in Jesus. I just want people to understand that he is so powerful. Oh. He can take what is probably the most broken person. I was so broken before. And the minute that I confessed that I needed him, that was the exact moment that my life started to pivot.
Yeah. See, I get everything but the introvert.
Let me explain some.
A hard time about being the extrovert. So.
Well, there's a mistaken thought process. Introverts aren't shy. Do you guys think I'm shy?
Oh, no. Oh, no.
No. Uh-uh. It's about, it's a hard time to be around people a lot. So Mike loves, he builds energy from people. And I don't. That's why I'm saying it's really important to understand there's people that are equipped and created in different ways. And we can all confess. It just might be in a different way. Mm-hmm. One-on-one instead of a group. Yes. But it's so important.
Absolutely. My wife is the same way.
Yeah.
Yeah. So did you understand that meaning and the difference? I hope that helps you, the listener, to decipher that it doesn't mean that you're shy or you don't talk.
Right, right.
It's a fill up area or a fill up time. Now, for me, I get filled up in the big crowds. Mm. My wife and you, Val, get filled up in the quiet.
Yes, and that just shows how beautiful God created us all to work in a symbiotic way. Christ's body is all, we're all different parts, but we all get to, if we all come together, it's so powerful. And then we meet his purposes in a really incredible way.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Hey, a couple shout outs today for Tony, who's struggling with cancer. We're praying for you, Tony. And James, we're praying for you, James. We have one of our own who is in recovery from a little surgery.
Mm-hmm.
And so a shout out to John and his wife, Terry. I'm sure she's taken really good care of him.
Yes.
And we hope for a speedy recovery so he gets back on his feet.
Yes.
Yeah. Real quick. So,
so he can come back and tease you as soon as possible.
Yeah, well, yeah, he's good at doing that. It gives me a hard time. So, but that's love. As
yes,
you say,
it's Val. In love.
Yes, yeah. Uh-huh.
I don't think he's convinced.
You can really feel it.
You know what?
Folks.
We're going to keep teasing him to show him the love so he understands. Yeah. That's where it's
there
coming
we go.
From.
Okay. You know, I want to.
Moving on.
Yeah, I want to also. There's an event today at Hilltop Church from 3 to 7 today. And there's going to be tons of games and food and candy.
Six tons of candy. Yes.
And yeah, yes. It's going to be a blast. So the most of the Recovery Radio team will be there. It's at 3180 McCulloch Boulevard from 3 to 7.
Yes.
So come down and say hello. Bring your kids. Even if you don't have kids, come down, say hello. Meet us. We'd love to see you. Some in costume, others won't be. I'm not much of a costume guy.
Yeah.
So this is it. It's as good as
what
it gets.
What you see is what you get.
That's about it. So
I appreciate that,
yeah,
Mike.
So we just keep going. That's all. So anyways, love to see you there. What do we have
for our scripture today?
Our scripture. Thank you.
Yes. James 5:16. Confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so you may be healed. The earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results.
Amen.
What yes. translation was that?
New Living Translation.
Okay.
Amen.
The NIV. Yeah. Good old NIV.
Well, there you go. Mm-hmm. There you go. So yes. our conversation today, we'll kick it off, is to confess.
Yes.
You know, how many times have you, do you remember growing up? Let's go back to childhood where something would happen.
Do we have to?
Yeah, we do. Yeah. But it's fun.
It's part of the...
It is kind of fun. I mean, I still act like a kid, so I'm there all the time.
No, I'm still in my childhood.
Yes,
I was just saying, you
yeah.
know, there's yeah. things I, that happened in my childhood.
There's some challenges, but yeah. let's go back to...
And I know in vows as well. And
yes.
To instances yeah. and times where you did something, and it's nice to have brothers and sisters because you simply blame them.
Oh.
Oh, see, I was the oldest of six, so I got to blame everybody.
You blamed everybody. Okay, yeah. So we're going to speak to you today, Bill, about how easy that is, and you become a little bit manipulative.
So, yes, it starts
you don't
so young.
Tell the truth. Yes. You don't admit that I broke that.
I never did. No,
yeah,
no.
Yeah. So, and you know, being the oldest, you have a little bit more authority or power usually over siblings.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Because you're the oldest. And,
yep.
But it's so easy to blame. And not confess and tell the truth. And
yeah.
and what habits
we
build right there. Yeah.
It's you know what? It's so interesting to think about that as a child. What's behind that? What's behind the hiding? What's behind not being able to feel like you can tell people things? Mm-hmm. I think there's a lot of fear behind that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes there's trauma yep. behind that. So it's different, yeah. I think, for every person. But what's important is that you investigate your own life and you do some self-analysis and figure out where it's coming from. That will help you to become more open and transparent. And the yeah. more you're in groups of people that live their life with radical honesty or radical transparency, it's easier for you to be that way as well. Mm-hmm. So I encourage the listeners that are out there to give us a call at 1-800-721-9313 if you're ready to be radically honest. We're here to listen.
Yeah, I look back as I said that. Let's go back to childhood, and I could see so many lies, so many patterns that kind of develop.
Yes,
You know, there's almost a shame now. Now you're doubling down. Now, you know, as your mom and dad kind of investigate this, and one says, well, I didn't do it and he did it, and then you blame and everything else, and then the truth finally comes out. It's like a double shame.
Yes.
Whereas, you know, and it's a learned process, but, you know, for some, like for me, it was a difficult process because I hid behind more lies, even as an adult, a lot. And it was just a pattern.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
you start to believe your lies
yes.
and then the cover up. And you know how much work it is to try and cover a lie rather than one time tell
yeah,
the truth.
Yeah, because you're continually building with another lie, and then another lie, and then another. And you can't remember what the first one was.
Yes.
And that's when you get caught. So it's always better to tell the truth.
And
I know when I was a kid that the main reason I would blame somebody else is because I was afraid of my dad's black belt.
Mm.
I did not like getting spanked.
Right.
And, you know, he was not afraid of, you know, sparing the rod.
Yeah.
He did not. And, you know, I even when I was like 14 or 15 years old, I remember having to pull my pants down and bend over the couch to get one because I had done something, you know. And I just, even in kindergarten, I would blame other kids for knocking the toys over or doing, you know, other stuff. It's just, it didn't just happen at home, you know, with my brothers and sisters. It happened everywhere I was at.
Yes.
And, you know, it just, I had anger issues and I could go on and on, but yeah, it was, thankfully I'm not that way anymore.
Yeah. You've changed. I've changed. Val's changed. Mm-hmm. I enjoy the truth because it's so much easier.
Yes. It's freeing.
Listen, it is freeing. It's so peaceful to tell the truth. Now there's ways of telling the truth. You just don't want to walk up to someone and say, oh, by the way, you know, I got to confess, you know, I've been having an affair with your wife for 2 years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I mean, there's a fine line of confession to hurt someone out of spite.
Yes.
Right.
Versus to tell someone that you actually care about them by telling them the truth.
I've learned that I have to check my motives before I do speak out in truth. Am I doing it in love? What is the reason behind why?
Yeah.
And another thing I wanted to mention, how we were talking about as children, we start building that. We want to blame other things. Even when you were in kindergarten, you were talking about blaming other kids for what you did. It's like, the more insidious thing about that is our world is built in such a way that actually you start to see good things happen in your life once you're rewarded in certain ways in this world. The more you lie and cover up, sometimes that creates, if you're lying about your abilities, you get the job that you shouldn't have maybe been able to get. Things like that happen and it kind of like allows you to keep going down that path thinking, well, I'm not really doing anything wrong. I'm not hurting anybody. But what it's doing is it's building this culture around you and within you.
A false persona.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And it's so hard to break free from that and break away from that. Luckily, we serve a God who is so powerful that he can break through anything.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it, you know, it's just so important to tell the truth. Mm. It's just... if not, let's face it, you're walking with Satan because there's no lie in God. There's pure truth and in his word and scripture and his promises and he keeps them. But Satan, man, king of lies.
Yes.
He just wants to destroy you. And what about your self-worth, trying to keep up with all of the facade and the fakeness and the lies and the look at me and to try and fit into the world because you're desperately wanting either companionship, love relationships. They say that when you're beginning to date someone and you're getting to know them, how many times have you gone through a process and if they don't capture you within 6 months of that, they usually leave because they've put a facade up for so long that they can't keep it up anymore.
Yeah.
Right.
And you know, how many times have we done that or you done that, the listener out there, to try and accomplish something that maybe you don't deserve, like the job.
Yes.
Within a relationship that it causes you all kinds of issues and problems and you continue to lie about it rather than tell the truth to straighten it out, to rebuild the relationship, you simply walk away from it.
Yeah.
Because you can't confess, you can't tell the truth. And, you know, I'm telling you, you said it, Bill, it will set you free.
Yes.
I mean, you'll be healed from it. And that's the whole thing. There's healing and revealing. If you reveal and you speak it and you say it, I said this Thursday, if you don't do that, your lie owns you. Anything you're hiding, that secret, it controls and owns you. But once you speak it and you say it to another human being, you can receive more love. You can receive understanding from people.
Support.
Yeah, there's so many things that will benefit you by just telling the truth. And, you know, I know it's not easy, especially if it's... something that we've carried for a while, and yes. we tuck away and we put away, and we don't want anybody to know, because if they know, they're never going to talk to us. They'll think less of us. And then, you know, I'll lose friends and my family and on and on. And, you know, that's just walking in darkness, because.
Can I say something about, I didn't mean to interrupt you, Mike. No. I just thought of something when you were talking about, you know, being able to be sensitive when you're exposing things. I think a really something that people need to hear that are listening that maybe haven't taken that bold step in confessing something about their life, whether that's hidden trauma or whether that's hidden sin, because usually that sin does originate with, you know, things that happen in our life, bad experiences we've had. We start to distrust people around us, even the closest people to us. It's important to build trust with somebody and have a safe place that you're able to share those things.
Yeah.
So I recommend just getting one-on-one with someone and having that accountability. Build that trust first, and then you'll be able to step out, you know, in faith and be able to discuss those things that are really, really difficult, maybe for the first time in your life. Maybe you've been a Christian. For me, I was a Christian for 17 years before I confessed the deepest, darkest things in my life. Mm-hmm. And I'm telling you, God radically changed my heart and perspective the very moment I started to speak about those things.
Yes. And you know, see, that's a great point about the heart, because who you are is what you carry in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a worldly person, a person that is a believer. What's in your heart, that will come out. That will come out in abruptness, in rudeness, in anger.
Yes.
In so many ways, because you carry that, and that's where it's hidden.
Mm.
And if you confess things, then God gives you that more of that pureness and that peace, and your heart actually just softens, and you're able to to feel better.
Right.
Finally, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just
it's a burden released.
So important. Mm. Wow. You know, when I had to confess, now I'm going to tell you, doing an inventory, and that's part of the 12-step program. So that's a great place to start. Find a meeting, find a church group, even within a Bible study or a small group,
mm-hmm.
to be able to talk to somebody that you trust, right? Maybe a one-on-one, just to speak it.
Mm-hmm.
And when you speak it, it's like a pressure valve that gets backed off, and ooh. Steam comes out. And man, oh man, it's so... Oh,
yes.
Man,
it's relieving.
It's relieving. Mm-hmm. Man, I've carried that secret for 23 years. You know what I mean?
Oh, yes, and, I do.
So, yeah. So I'm sure the listeners can hear that. So,
yes.
Listen, we'd love to hear from you. 1-800-721-9313. And the local Havasu number, 928-855-9110. You know, I thought just the opposite within confession for a long time. I carried many, many things. I did a ton of bad things, and hid mm-hmm. them from relationships, and tried to cover that lie with another lie or a situation. And it was, you know, if I look at it, the whole thing was, it was about me.
Wow.
It was self-seeking.
Yes.
It was always about me or for me. And I just kept it that way for the longest of times. And it just brought me down darker paths.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that the listeners can relate and have been there. Maybe you're there still right now today, mm-hmm. and you kind of can't claw your way out. You don't know what to do. You don't know where to find that peace. You don't know, where do I start? Well, first of all, you can simply start, whether you believe in God or not, you can simply confess to him in the air. God, if you're real, I have something to talk about. I want to confess something. And I'm going to tell you, God is going to meet you right there.
Yes.
And he's going to show you who he is. And then he's going to bring somebody into your life. And you're going to be able to speak that same thing that you just told God to them. Because now you're telling a human being face to face. And when you do that, you are free from carrying whatever it is for the rest of your life.
And this is not a new way, a new program. This is biblical. This is thousands and thousands of years old. If we confess with our mouth, Jesus will save us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if we confess of our sins to each other and pray for each other, you will be healed.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's pretty powerful. Again, another promise by God. And if you work that process, and again, it's, you know, it's not easy, Val.
No,
it's not easy. It's like, you know, okay, well, I'm going to go tell somebody and, you know, I'm going to have a conversation with them. Mm-hmm. You know, it has to be the right situation, and you have to be peaceful in your heart, mm-hmm. and not vicious, mm-hmm. and be able to talk about that. And I'm going to tell you, you will get through it. You will survive. And even though you don't think you will, because it's so heavy and nobody will understand, and this is going to be really, really difficult, but there is a way out. And by you confessing, you'll be able to process that.
Yes. And I want to say something about the effects of PTSD that I learned when I was in an inpatient rehab facility. When you are lying and covering, a lot of times, well, in my case, a lot of that started and developed from trauma that I never dealt with. So it just got bigger and bigger. The snowball got bigger and bigger. So it took a lot of practice after I started revealing things and started talking about things. In fact, initially, I didn't take that bold step. I wasn't brave enough. It was revealed, and it was a public humiliation. I was being investigated for drug diversion at the hospital I worked at. So God knew what I needed in order to break through to my heart. I see that as a rescue. I don't see that as a humiliation anymore.
Isn't that amazing that you could just confess that now, Val?
Yes.
Isn't it so
freeing? Because it's the truth. It's the truth.
It is. It is. And I'm so glad that you said that, because other people can hear, holy smokes. Did I hear what she said? And that's real life, because mm-hmm. we have many real life situations, and if we pretend that it doesn't exist, here's a good word: denial.
Yeah,
right. Denial.
Yeah. Denial. Yeah.
I don't really have a situation. It is a big river.
Yeah,
yes. Yeah, and it is a big bunch of
And so I share that to say to the listener, if you are holding on to something, don't let it get to the point where you're being held legally responsible for your bad life choices. And another thing about the PTSD that I was getting to is when I started learning that all those years of covering and hiding things, your brain literally will wire itself to continue to do that, because you are in survival mode. Your brain thinks you will not survive if you don't continue doing what you've learned to do to cope with these things. So when you start making those changes, it takes a lot of intention and a lot of practice, a lot of support. So I just wanted to put that out there to remind people that it's not an overnight thing. You touched on how challenging it is. It's an excruciating process, but it's also a very beautiful, revealing. It's very painful, but you will be so amazed by what God does in that. And you'll be able to walk with somebody else who maybe that's someone who would have taken their life, and you're able to walk with them through that challenge. And God did that for that very purpose. Mm-hmm. He's arranging things in their favor, and you might be part of that plan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just by speaking, just by saying, hey, I here's what I did, and I could use some help. Mm-hmm. And then you realize that, you got some people around you that have walked the same walk. Oh yeah. Oh, that was tough for me. Here's how I did it. And you're amazed. How many times do we think that we're alone, or our sin is unique? I love that.
No one could be as bad as me. I'm the worst.
I thought that. I thought, oh my gosh, man, I am the worst of the worst. Mm-hmm. When you know,
Paul thought that too.
He did. And, yes. You know, God saw gives what us he did, that great example of, can you imagine what he carried? Think about this scenario, killing about 1,000 people by your sword, children. There was probably some torture, some beatings,
stonings.
All of that process. Can you imagine carrying that and not want anybody to know who you are, where you've been, what you've done?
Yeah.
And yet, through Jesus Christ, all of that was taken away.
Right.
And restored for him to do a good works for God.
Yes.
And what a great example. I use him all the time, the worst of the worst, because I thought I was the worst of the mm-hmm. worst. I really did.
Yeah.
I thought, look at what a human being I've turned into because of my lies and my choices and my self-seeking and it being all about me.
Mm-hmm.
I had become a whole nother person. My family says today, you are a different person than you used to be. Well, that's what Paul went through.
Yeah.
The transformation of being such a wretch that I was. I called myself a scumbucket for the longest time. And I felt that and I lived that and God restored me and made me brand new. And it's through the confession that you continue to heal.
Yes.
And you change your personality mm-hmm. change. First of all, your heart changes.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Right?
That's
so
right.
When you have that peace and you have the want to help, want to do for others instead of yourself, you completely change.
Mm.
But it starts with you have to step out of denial.
Yeah.
You have to admit that I got a situation. I got a problem. I've been drinking too much, or I'm watching too much porn, or I'm so angry all the time, and I'm yelling and screaming at the family, and I'm sick of the politics, and I'm sick of the world, and what's going on, and everybody's against everybody,
mm-hmm.
and you got to wear these stupid masks, and you're allowing all of that to build up, and mm-hmm. you tuck it in, and then, you know, you explode on the people that you love, and you can get help by saying, man, I call it my fussy stage. I'm fussy, and I'll tell Polly that I'm a little worn down today. I'm kind of fussy, and she knows.
Yeah.
I don't have to pretend that everything is all good and it's fine. No, I'm fine. You know that word, fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm fine. I used to say that all the time, and I was a complete walking disaster trying to put a facade on to pretend that I've got my life together.
Yes.
And it was a mess.
Yeah, being transformed is not about, holding up this facade anymore. It's not about being perfect all the time. It's about walking in your truth. It's about stepping into who God created you to be. And people don't relate with other people who are pretending they have it all together. Human beings can see straight through that inauthenticity. So I'm just encouraging the listeners right now, give us a call at 1-800-721-9313 if you want to tell us a story about your transformation or even confess for the first time. We'd love to hear from you.
Yeah. You know, people can't see you. You don't have to, if you don't want your name to be said, but to be able to talk about something is by far the best thing. It's something I never did, Val, ever. I would never tell anybody that... I had some challenges. I call them flaws, you know what I mean? Because I had to try and hold it together to pretend. But it goes right back to childhood, maybe high school and on and on. I mean, I fit in. I tried to fit in with three kinds of groups. I played sports, so I fit in with the jocks. I was a pretty smart kid, so I mingled with the brainies. And then I hung around the stoners.
Question. Pretty and smart or pretty smart?
Well, there was nothing pretty about me, that's for sure. But I was semi-smart. Let's change that, Val. You see what I have to put up with in this studio?
Yeah.
It's all love. I told you, it's all love.
Yeah. But as I look back, and maybe you've done the same thing within your childhood, that you pretend, you pretend to be something that you're not.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then you lose that honesty. And then you begin, isn't it amazing how when you lie and you cover up another lie, you actually begin to believe your own lies.
Mm-hmm.
And you get caught up within that whole merry-go-round of trying to juggle so many different personality type things to please people. Maybe you're a people pleaser and you're losing your self identity, and you have you feel like you have no self worth, and on and on. And and it's really simple conversation and getting some help. And we have Listen, we have so many resources.
Yes.
On the computer, if you can go to RecoveryRadioLHC.com, it will open up a whole area of resources, mm-hmm. from books to meetings to hotlines,
yes.
to be able to communicate. You can call somebody, you can talk to them, and you can send us an email even, and we will respond to that.
Yes.
And, you know, that's why I say better together. Once you let that out, we share it. It's like walking down the road with 12 bricks. You're walking next to somebody. Mm-hmm. They're carrying all the bricks.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, I got a partner right here, but I don't want to tell him or ask him about carrying the bricks because these are my bricks, and it wears us down.
It's exhausting.
You know what I mean? It's exhausting, yeah. mm-hmm. to do. And if you confess it and say, hey, will you help me with 6 bricks?
Mm.
And together, now you each have 6 bricks, and it makes the burdens so much lighter.
Yeah.
That's what God does.
Yes.
He comes alongside of us. And he helps
takes
us.
All of them.
And then all of a sudden, you're carrying no bricks.
Yeah.
And doesn't that make for a lighter walk?
Yeah. And he brings people in our lives that are willing to take those bricks, yes. from us.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And and that's a brand new life. I mean, that's what we have in the studio today. We all of us, from our producers to the simulcast people to the people answering phones, as a team, we all have a brand new life.
Yes.
And it's only through, yeah. Jesus Christ, period.
Yeah, period.
I mean, that's it. That's it. So if you're struggling with something today and you would like to talk, man, give us a call.
Mm-hmm. And you don't even have to come on the radio. Sorry.
No, you don't. You're right. You don't.
Mm-hmm.
We'll get a message into the studio here, and we will pray for you.
Yes. That's Mike was about to say 1-800-721-9313. I'm all about interrupting him today. And my husband warned me about that. He watched the show and he's like, you need to stop interrupting Mike Cardello.
Oh, no, you interrupt anytime. Listen, we're in this together. I did it last night when I was hanging around. I had an agenda before this little puny mind forgot something right as Jesse's ready to pray. Oh, Val, by the way, don't forget to say this. And I just remembered that we didn't say it. So,
oh. See?
So I want to get this out because we miss it every week. And I just want to remind the listener that not everybody is up at our hour on Saturday morning.
Yeah.
Right? So we do a replay of this show every Wednesday night from 1 to 2 o'clock in the morning, Bill?
It's Tuesday night, Wednesday morning.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
From 1 to 2.
Okay, so it actually, it really is Tuesday
night,
Wednesday morning from, yep. 1 to 2.
Yes.
So you can pass that along for people that work night shift and, mm-hmm. maybe you get off at midnight. They'll be able to hear a show. So
yeah.
Just a reminder that we do a replay of this show. So.
Or maybe you're on the other side of the world where it's daytime.
You're right.
It is, yes. worldwide.
It is. Yes. Now we've heard from Africa and Pastor Jared and it is probably in the dead of night over there right now. So it's 10 to 12 hours difference. So
yeah.
So they are a day ahead of us, I believe. Actually,
yes.
Time ahead of us. So
yeah. Yeah, it's probably Sunday there by now. Mm. Pretty close.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, pretty close. You're right. Yeah. It probably is. Yeah, very close. So. We'd love to hear from you in any way or form. If you want to text us, we'll get that message here, yeah. in the studio.
Yeah.
You know, I found that the burden of for me of telling the truth, because it was a burden, because it exposes us, that we've either done wrong or said something wrong or have hurt someone, and think of how you would feel if someone hurt you or said something about you that's wrong, to create gossip, to create a situation that affects your life.
Yes.
To go to that person and make amends, ask for forgiveness, to apologize, is huge. It's first of all, it benefits another human being that you actually care enough to do that. And that's what Christ teaches us all the time, right? I mean, look at us. So, and Scripture says, well, listen, if you don't forgive someone else, God won't forgive you. I mean, it's a simple process.
Right.
That's what teaches us. So it's learned behavior. Oh, I need to make an amends, man. I think I hurt that person. Didn't mean to, didn't want to, but I think I need to go at least apologize and express my concern of I didn't want to do you wrong or say anything wrong, and I certainly apologize for it. That's confession. That's confessing, man.
Yes.
And it brings people together.
Yeah.
I mean, how many families don't even talk to each other over a situation or a problem? I haven't talked to him in 20 years, and there's no reason to.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Where does that get you within the world? It allows you to carry that anger and that hatred. You know, anger turns into hatred. Just look at the
real
viciousness,
quick.
You know, within what's happening today in the world.
Yeah.
It's so chaotic. Love is gone. Our moral compass is gone so far out of whack. The respect and the kindness and caring for another human being. It's really a steamroll community, it seems like, lately within the world. You just roll right over somebody that's down. But it's not new. Again, here we're talking about today. What about the person in Scripture that everybody walked by? He was robbed and everything else, and priests even came by him and didn't help him, didn't do anything, and you had finally a good Samaritan that mm-hmm. helped a man who was beaten and robbed and hurt. How many people went by him, Bill?
Yeah, exactly.
So many.
Yeah,
and then one person came and helped that person through his struggle.
Yes.
So again, here we think, you know, okay, because of the pandemic and all that's going on within the world, we have challenges and struggles. It's been happening for thousands of years.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Ever since the garden.
Yeah.
So, Bill, I think we have a caller on line 4, Anthony, and he wanted to talk to us a little bit.
Good morning, Anthony. Welcome to Recovery Radio.
Jesus, this is really neat how this is going on. And then there was a pause, and I said to myself, God wouldn't do this. Jesus wouldn't do this. Mm. You know, and I got so mad at the devil, you know, I said, this is it. I ain't doing it no more. And because it after you do something like that, it hurts you. You know, it eats at you. But what about the other person, you know, that you did it to? Uh-huh. You know, it's like stabbing them in the heart.
Yeah.
And you know, I have everybody I've been with that I could find, and the people I was married to, I asked forgiveness from them.
Amen.
And they forgave me.
Yeah.
I even drove to Albuquerque from Arizona to meet one of the people, and this was after 30 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
But see, in that instance, though, she's the one that did that, not me. But still, I've done my share of bad stuff, and so I do have to admit that it is wrong, and I don't understand why people think it's so right when they get mad at their spouse or somebody to go and do that.
Yes.
And I'm asking people that are listening, if you're doing it right, doing it now, to stop.
Yes.
Go somewhere and pray. Somewhere and sit down and pray, and then go back and tell that other person, I'm sorry, I can't see you no more.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They may end up losing that person and their spouse, but it's all right. They're not going to lose their soul.
Yes.
Yes. And that's exactly it, Anthony, to confess. I mean, that's
right.
That's what, because we carry that burden. I was also in the same position. I was an adulterer and cheated over and over until I accepted Christ, and then that changed my life. And I had to do the same thing. I had to go back and make some phone calls and have conversation with people and apologize. But you know what? It's cleansing.
But you have to be sincere, though.
Yes, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
You know?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Because, you know, there's people like I remember with some of these, like Richard Nixon or some other people. The only reason some people apologize is because they get caught.
Right.
You know, or they keep on doing stuff mm-hmm. like today.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, yeah, if people are out there committing adultery, or even if they're not married, you need to know the person. You need to, you know, don't just want to go to bed with them.
Yeah.
Because that's not right. That's not what Jesus and God wants. So that's the first thing. Let me add something else to this. When you're younger, you know, you get upset and everything, and sometimes you turn to alcohol. I never was an alcoholic, but I drank enough to try to, you know, get through it and have a little fun, you know. And one day I looked in the bottle and I thought, well, Jesus isn't down there. So I've told people that have a drinking problem, look in your bottle. Mm-hmm. I said, do you see Jesus down there? I said, hey, you're not going to find him in your bottle. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I ask people that drink and do drugs and everything, quit making excuses. You just say, look, I'm doing wrong and I need to fix it.
Yeah, and there's, you know, Anthony, there's so many resources mm-hmm. and so many people that would be willing to come alongside of you. I had the same issues, and I'm so thankful that there were people there. And we want to give that hope to people that are struggling with that. But
don't you think that no matter how many people are around, you have to say to yourself, I'm done.
Yes.
Yeah.
I need to fix this.
Yes.
Yeah.
And follow the prompting of the Holy Spirit like you did, Anthony.
You do. Yeah. But you know, some people don't know the Holy Spirit. So that's when you have to step in and help them. But you have to not make excuses, and you just got to quit making excuses. That's all I got to say.
That's right. That's right. Confess. When you say, hey, I can't do this anymore, I need some help, guess who shows up? That's right. And you got to be willing. Anthony, thank you so much this morning, man.
I got one more.
Oh, you got one more. Okay.
To do.
Okay.
This is not for me, but see, I have written, and I'm going to mention some names because some people are actually voting for some of these people.
I'm sorry, Anthony. Hang tight for me one second. We don't want to mention any names, if that's okay.
Okay, then.
Yeah, well, yeah, we can't do that. Sorry.
Okay. Well, there's certain politicians that I have written to because I'm 62 years old, and I have been around, and I know what they do. So I wrote to these people, and I told them, you know, you don't have very much longer to live. Don't you think you ought to, you know, have a little talk with Jesus and God and ask forgiveness of your sins? And because there's only two places you're going to go when you die. And so I was very sincere with them. I don't know if they got my emails or not, but could you guys at least pray for these people out there? Because I know you know who they are.
Yes,
we need to pray for them because the election day is on.
Prayer is the answer.
Prayer is
the answer for sure.
And ask Jesus and God and the Holy Spirit to, I don't know, give them some kind of a message.
Amen. Amen.
Anthony, thank you so much for calling.
We got another call. We're running out of time. Anthony, man, thank you so much, man, for your call. Love you, man.
Right.
Good
God
job.
Bless you. Right.
You too. Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Good morning, Ann.
Good morning, Mike. Good morning, Val. How are you?
Good. Thank you. Good morning.
Well, I turned you guys on, actually. I'm 2 hours ahead of you guys. But, you know, you guys were talking about secrets and with everything going on today. I have a lot of friends and a lot of support. But secrets are a hard thing because when they come out, you know, you lose a lot of friends and you lose a lot of support. You know, I deal in a lot of secrets. And there's one that I'm struggling with a lot. And if it comes out, I'm going to lose a lot of my friends and a lot of support that I think, you know, I'm assuming.
Yes.
And it's very difficult, especially, you know, with today's times. So how do you just come out and say, you know, your secret?
Mm-hmm. I think that for me, the best way I was able to do it is first I confessed to God, and then I found one person that I trusted and just talked with them through it. I didn't choose to speak about it with a group of people until I was able to speak about it with one person, because it helped me process through. I know you might have a bunch of people in your life that you feel that you could trust with that. But that's really important. I think for me, as someone who really, really struggled with that, with speaking out about things that I kept hidden for so long, really dark things, mm-hmm. I chose one person that I fully trusted and spoke to them face to face, and they helped me process through. Sometimes that's a counselor that you don't know and doesn't know you. Mm-hmm. Sometimes that's the safest place. But the main thing is to find a safe person, and what that means to each person is different.
It does, yes. And you know, you don't, I like that value, you don't have to kind of shout it out and mm-hmm. raise your hand and say, mm-hmm. this is what I've done in front of everybody. It's a, you know, it's a very personal, private moment.
Yes.
And through that, God, I promise you, whether you believe or you don't believe, will
I'm
help.
A believer.
Amen. See, he already knows it. He knows what yes. you've done. So you're actually just speaking it. You're speaking it to him in a prayer to help bring that person. Mm-hmm. to your life, so that there's understanding. And listen, a lot of times through confession, we need comfort
yes.
through that. So there's got to be a kind, caring person mm-hmm. rather than pointing a finger and said, man, I can't believe you did that. You're a blah, 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 and on and on. And we don't need to. God will put the right person through your prayer mm-hmm. and asking him to be able to confess what's taken place.
Yes.
And he'll be faithful. And you have to trust that process.
And the hardest part about that, Anne, is when you you've already done it. You've already spoken out that, hey, I'm struggling with keeping this secret. Right there, God knows your heart, and you've already confessed to him. So thank you so much for calling, and we really appreciate that you shared that with us. I know it must have been really hard for you.
Thank you, Anne. We're winding down. We have like 2 minutes to close yes. the show. Thank you so much. We'll be praying for you. Yes. Okay.
Thank you guys
much. We'd love to hear from you again. Thank yes. you, Anne.
Thanks, guys.
Okay.
Have a good one.
Bye bye.
God bless. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Val, that was the quickest hour. We are down to like 2 minutes. I'm looking yeah. at the clock going, Bill, did you wind
no,
that thing up
no.
or what has taken place? Well,
yes.
Let's begin just the process. Hey, listen, next week's show, man, we have the mayor of Lake Havasu
Mr.
City.
Sheehy.
Yeah, can't wait. We were talking about him this morning. We'll have
yeah.
a blast. We'll ask him lots of questions on, can you imagine? Kind of being responsible about running a city and dealing with
and
business owners
hits.
And the pandemic and masks and no masks and decisions and everything yeah. else. And he's got a bucket full of stuff
yes.
that he's got to
yep.
carry around to take care of. So
yep.
That's going to be a lot. That'll be a fun show.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to that.
Mm-hmm.
Val, you want to begin to close us in prayer?
Yes, I'd love to. Heavenly Father, as we bow our heads before you and confess, we have too often forgotten that we are yours. Sometimes we carry on our lives as if you don't even exist, and we fall short of being credible witnesses. For this and our many other shortcomings, we ask forgiveness. Remind us to be who you would have us to be, and in Jesus' precious name, amen.
Amen. And you know, for those that were on the line and we couldn't get to you, we're praying for you. Send
yes.
us an email. We really care about what you're going through, and we pray for you all week anyway. So
mm-hmm.
Really important. Go to RecoveryRadioLHC.com.
Yes.
We thank you for our team. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, Val.
You're welcome.
Great show. We really, really appreciate you, the listener, and our sponsors. We're so thankful for you and our team. Remember, keep coming back. We're better together. I'm your host, Mike, and I'll see you next week on the radio. Have a great week. Val's dancing.
Goodbye for now from Recovery Radio, where we have hope for you. dear.